Horses are one of the first animals domesticated by humans. All subsequent times, horses have been constant companions of people. They were harnessed to war chariots, freight carts, and passenger carts. Horses pulled the plow behind them and carried riders. Just 100 years ago, the main combat unit of any army in the world was the cavalryman. But before becoming one of man's best friends, these strong and noble animals had to go through a long evolutionary path. In addition, the horses made a long journey in order to return to their historical homeland. From our videos, you can learn many interesting facts about the origin of various animals. To be the first to know about the release of the next episode, just subscribe to the Age of Dinosaurs channel. We also encourage viewers to more actively express their opinions about our work and support the creators of the channel with likes. Horses are equid animals. In addition to them, this group also includes tapirs and rhinoceroses. They are characterized by an odd number of fingers. During the process of evolution, the middle finger of these animals gradually grew larger and turned into a hoof. This device serves to speed up running due to a smaller contact patch with the ground. Hooves appeared due to the fact that ancestors of modern horses were forced to change their place of residence and lifestyle. Ancient horses, which bore little resemblance to horses, zebras, and donkeys that we're used to, were forest animals. Climate change has led to the emergence of vast steppes. To survive, they had to adapt to new living conditions. Hyracotherium is considered the earliest known ancestor of modern equids. Also, some scientists have identified an animal, such as Eoclib, into a separate genus. But according to modern classification, they are considered varieties of one creature that lived in different territories. The remains of animals found in the United States and Mexico were assigned to the genus Eohippus. Hyracotherium also lived in Europe and Asia. The remains of Eohippus are between 55 and 50 million years old, and the Hyracotherium settled across Eurasia several millions of years later. This means that North America can be considered the historical homeland of horses. Because the latest research says that these animals belong to the same genus, from now on, we can call them Hyracotheriums. They had a height of no more than 50 centimeters and a body length of 70 centimeters. Hyracotherium weighed less than 10 kilograms. These animals most likely ate soft leaves, plant shoots, fruits, and nuts. They themselves were the prey of large carnivorous birds from the Ferraricosidae family. They had 4 toes on their front legs and 3 toes on their hind legs. On the bottom of each toe, there was a pad similar to those now found on the paws of dogs. These small animals lived in forests. Among the characteristics inherent in modern horses, one can only highlight the structure of the teeth of the Hyracotherium. Over the next 10 to 20 million years, new species of proto-horses appeared in both America, Eurasia, and Africa. They were taller than the Hyracotherium. Judging by the structure of their limbs, they could develop much greater running speed. Scientists suggest that at this time, the ancestors of horses began to leave the forests and make short forays into the steppe. Orohippus. These still small animals were direct descendants of the Eohippus. They lived in the United States approximately 40 to 50 million years ago. Their height did not exceed 40 centimeters, but in some ways they already resembled modern horses. The legs of the Orohippus were better suited for jumping. The shape of the skull of this animal is very similar to that of a horse, only in size it was no larger than a dog. Despite the fact that the name of this prehistoric horse translates as mountain horse, these animals never lived in the mountains. Propaleotherium. Similar animals also appeared in Europe at this time. Propaleotherium was not related to modern horses. This creature belonged to an extinct side branch of the equid order. It lived in Western Europe approximately 45 to 50 million years ago. Its height did not exceed 60 centimeters, and in some species, even 30 centimeters, and its body length was up to 50 centimeters. It weighed no more than 6 kilograms. Its legs were short, and its structure was similar, mostly to the Hyracotherium. Mesohippus. Approximately 30 to 40 million years ago, the first tridactyl horses appeared in North America. Their third finger was significantly longer than the second and fourth. When walking, Mesohippus rested only on it, but it was not yet a full-fledged hoof. On the lower part of the finger, there was the same pad as the Hyracotherium or the Orohippus. These horses were larger than their ancestors. Their height reached 60 centimeters, the body length 120 centimeters. They also had a larger skull. Their brain structure was similar to the brain of a modern horse. Mesohippus fed on plant shoots, soft leaves, and fruits. Now scientists have identified more than 10 species of Mesohippus that lived in different areas. Myohippus. Despite the name, which means Miocene horse, Myohippus appeared at the end of the Oligocene. Unlike the extinct Mesohippus, these larger horses flourished until about the middle of the Mesocene era. Their skeleton was proportionally larger than that of their ancestors. This horse already weighed 40 to 55 kilograms. By the beginning of the Oligocene, the number of forests in North America had sharply decreased. Most of the continent was covered with endless grassy plains, prairies. In the search for new habitats, the ancestors of horses began to explore the steppes. This led to major changes in their body structure. First of all, the changes affected the size as well as the structure of the legs and teeth. Only those species of odd-toed ungulates survived that were able to switch to new food, began running faster, and could notice a creeping predator in the tall grasses. Horses of this time can already be considered transitional forms from primitive species to modern ones. Epegippus. This ancient horse, also called Epegippus, they lived in North America approximately 38 to 46 million years ago. They have not yet greatly exceeded their previous species in size. Parahippus. Appearing about 20 million years ago, his height was already about 1 meter at the withers. The muzzle and legs of Parahippus became more elongated, and the lateral fingers became vestiges. Merigippus. After another 10 million years, horses began to grow and grew to about 450 kilograms. This is comparable to the mass of some modern breeds. They have seriously increased their speed movement, but the main changes were associated with the structure of the teeth and oral muscles. No wonder the name of this horse is translated as ruminant horse. By the end of the Miocene era and the beginning of the Pleistocene era, the number of equid species increased sharply. They were already very similar to modern horses. These animals were ideally suited for the life in the steppe. Among them, the following genera stood out: Protogippus, Pleogippus, Hipparion, and Gepidion. The remains of representatives of the first two genera have been found only in North America, and the Hippoparions and Gidipidions settled in other territories. Hippoparions, which were up to 1.4 meters tall, crossed the Bering Strait approximately 11 million years ago. Their fossilized bones are found in Eurasia and Africa, and 9.5 million years ago, they appeared on the territory of the Indian Peninsula. Smaller Hippopotamians migrated to South America about 2.5 to 3 million years ago. But most scientists are sure that the Hippoparions were a dead-end branch of development. The ancestors of modern horses could be the dinosaur Ippus or the so-called American zebra. They belong to the same genus as living horses, zebras, and donkeys. Dinohippus was also a native inhabitant of North America. This animal lived here for almost 7 million years at the junction of the Pliocene and Pleistocene era. The Hagerman's horse, or American zebra, is considered intermediate between the Miocene and more modern varieties. According to various estimates, she weighed from 110 to 385 kilograms. Her remains are found throughout almost all of North America. For unknown reasons, approximately 10,000 years ago, all equids on both American continents became extinct. This may be due to the fact that around this time, a new predator appeared there: humans. Horses reappeared in these places only after Europeans began colonizing America. And now, they carried on their backs the people who had come to seize the homeland of their distant ancestors. And only a few of them stopped being pets and began being free on the expanses of the American prairies. We express our gratitude to the viewers who watched this video to the end. For previous issues, you can learn more of the evolution of other modern and extinct animals. Our channel also discusses environmental issues and modern society.